Hello and welcome to Dynamic Medicos. In this video, I am going to talk about Ophidia group of remedies. If you are new to my channel, then please do like and subscribe to my channel and press on the bell icon. Now let's move ahead with the introduction. In the animal kingdom, one of the large families contributing various drugs to homeopathy is Ophidia group. The Ophidia group contains serpents or snakes proper. The snake is one of the most ancient and most grandiose mythological character. The snakes have been playing greater role in medical history and Hindu philosophy since ages. Snakes are fascinating part of nature. Their color, movement, and secretive habits make them seem more mysterious than other animals. For example, who are especially interested in the wildlife, snakes are wonderful introduction to the world of nature. Constituents of snake venom. Snake poison contains fibrinolysins, proteolysins, neurotoxins, cholinesterase, predominant in a alapid viper, hemolysins, predominant in viper venom, thromboplastin, predominant in viper venom, agglutinins, cardiotoxin, coagulase hyaluronidase, helps venom to spread rapidly. Now let's see what are the medicinal value of the snake venom. Cobra poison used to relieve pain due to the neural leprosy. It can also cure cancer. Viper venom used as hemostat, used in hemophilia during major surgery to stop the hemorrhages. Poison of rattlesnake is used as medicine for epilepsy, nerve exhaustion. Certain snake venoms are used as local agent to treat the rheumatism, inflammation of joints, and neuralgic conditions. Important remedies of the snake group: Lachesis trigonocephalus, that is Surucucu snake; Naja tripudiens, that is cobra venom; Aleps corallinus, that is coral snake; Crotalus horridus, that is rattlesnake; Crotalus cascavella, that is Brazilian snake; Bothrops lanceolatus, that is yellow viper; Vipera berus, that is German viper; Hydrophis cyanocinatus, sea snake; Toxicophis, mucassin snake. Now let's see the doctrine of signature. The snake is extremely sensitive to heat, so it lives in deep burrows where it is cooler. A patient of Ophidia group is worse from warmth by hot drinks, in sun and in summer. Second is, the snake is more ferocious and poisonous when hungry. The patient of Ophidia group is aggravated by fasting and better by after eating. Next is, snakes are poisonous. When we say the mind is poisoned, it means that there is a jealousy and suspicion. Suspicion and jealous are the characteristic symptoms of the patients. The snake coils itself from left to right. Symptoms of Ophidia group are preceded from left to right, except for Crotalus and Aleps, as they are right-sided. Immediately after the snake bite, the blood is let out from that site and therapeutic measure to limit the extent of damage. General relief from bleeding and any other discharges. The snake is very sensitive to touch and vibrations. Patient is also aggravated by touch and slight sound. The snakes can swallow relatively large creatures easily due to the pressure created by solids in the throat. It can easily swallow the solids. Patient can swallow solids easily. The stools of snakes are black and offensive. The discharges in Ophidia group are dark and offensive. Classification of snake venom. There are five types: hemotoxin venom, myotoxic venom, neurotoxic venom, cytotoxic venom, and hemorrhagic envenoming. Characteristics of Ophidia group. Constitution: hemorrhagic constitution. Skin shows purple or mottled appearance. They are very much restless people. Face is sickly pale, anxious, bloated dark red or bluish. Miasm: syphilitic and tubercular background. Temperament is melancholic. Hemorrhagic diathesis. Thermal relationship: all the Ophidians are hot patient except for Aleps and Naja, which are chilly. Ailments from fright, jealousy, alcoholism, onanism, loss of vital fluids, suppressed menses, physical trauma, bad effects of poisons, long-lasting grief, disappointed love, vexation, summer and spring. Sphere of action: nerves, especially the pneumogastric and spinal accessory, cellular tissues, skin, circulation, cardiovascular system, brain, liver, throat, muscles. The pathophysiological action of the venoms: the neurotoxic venom causes the muscular weakness and paralysis involving the muscle of face, throat, respiration, legs. It acts as primarily on the motor nerves. The vascular toxic venom produces enzymatic destruction of the cell walls and coagulation disorders. As a result, the destruction of endothelium of blood vessels occurs. The myotoxic venoms produces generalized muscle pain followed by myoglobinuria. 3 to 5 hours later, ending in respiratory failure in fatal cases. The poisons of the Ophidians decomposes the blood, making it more fluid and non-coagulable, resulting in hemorrhage. The hemolytic venom will cause breakdown of RBCs, separating plasma and hemoglobin, which brings down the oxygen carrying capacity, resulting into a cyanosis. The venom produces local inflammation, agonizing pain, and erysipelas, swelling at the site of injury, rapidly passing into gangrene, foul ulcers, and absorption of the venom by lymphatic glands or through the veins, resulting in the pyemia. Characteristics: mind symptoms, anxiety, mental excitement and fear. Fear is a basic mental feature. It leads to nervous depression. Hallucinations are regularly seen. Loquacity: the Ophidians as a group is characterized by their loquacity. They are compelled to talk continuously. They jump from one topic to another without any connection. Make speeches in selective phrases. Suspicious: there is a fear of being poisoned, which causes him to refuse the medicines offered. These people are suspicious because of their survival instincts. Fear of disease and death. Religious insanity: there is a state of religious melancholy and clairvoyance. Thinks he is under the control of some supernatural power. Delirium: muttering like when drunk. This stage is carried into unconsciousness and further to coma. Fastidious: hurried tendency with much fastness in doing things. irritable and quarrelsome. Competitiveness and attractiveness is a common character of all the ophidians. Double standards. Ophidians are known to have two sets of rules, one for themselves and other for others, because of the egotism and jealousy, hallucination, delusion, insanity and delirium. Misanthropy. Secretiveness, quarrelsome, as if surrounded by enemies. Greedy, jealous, quarrelsome, malicious, and always playing dirty tricks. Solitude. Obscene gestures are made often. Hydrophobia and rage at sight of water. Active ophidians have an active memory and a very striking nature. Characteristic physical symptom. Hemorrhagic diathesis. Dark red blood and oozes profusely from every orifices of the body. Dark red blood. The blood is dark red and changes rapidly into a purplish color. Dark spots appear on the body. And blood settles into ecchymosis, thus a mottled purple appearance. Petechial hemorrhages or spots seen. Sight. All ophidians are left-sided except for crotalus and elaps. Pains. All ophidians pain go from left to right except for crotalus and elaps. Gangrene. Decomposition of blood with death of tissue leading to gangrene. Ulcers bleed black blood, which soon coagulate and looks like a charred straw. Congestive pains are felt in a head. Gums bleed easily and blood is seen around the teeth. Hematuria is very often listen. Flushes of heat are also with congestion, purity and rapid decomposition. Septicemia. Patient exhibit symptoms like that of septicemia. Hypersensitiveness. A marked feature of all the ophidians, especially of slight noise or touch, to motion, to cover and to walk on floor. Great sensitiveness of nostrils and lips. The mere touch of finger and hand is unbearable. Cannot wear tight clothes and tight bandages around the neck. Waist. Debility and prostration. There is a great debility and prostration. It often leads to collapse condition afterwards. Inflammation of cellular tissue leading to effusion of inner organs and septicemia. Paralysis of all ophidians have their characteristic action upon nerves. There is torpidity, numbness, twitching and fornications. Constrictiveness. The ophidians have constrictiveness or choking sensation due to the irritation of pneumogastric nerve. There is the presence of diphtheria and yellow mucus from the mouth. Dryness of the skin. Inability to sweat. Discharges. The discharges of ophidians are very offensive, profuse, bloody and dark. Suppression of these discharges give rise to complaints. Periodicity of complaints seen during spring, before and after menses. Cravings for alcoholic drinks, cold drinks and oysters. General modalities. aggravation from morning, sleep, noise, jar, suppression of discharges, summer, touch and night. Amelioration from cold, appearance of discharges when awake. Now let's see the some important symptoms of different snake remedies. First, let's see the Naga tripudens. It's an Indian cobra with quality of nobility, morality and responsibility, feeling of having suffered wrong and neglect, wants to harm the offending person but somehow controls himself, intense spiritual orientation, sadness with suicidal insanity, broods constantly over imaginary troubles which cannot be rectified, dreams of snakes flying and being pursued, suffocation from tight clothing, stitching pain in the region of heart. Next is Crotalus horridus. It's a rattlesnake. They are found to be more useful in malignant conditions like black water fever, loquacity, low muttering, forgetfulness, they forget their name, places, numbers, dreams are horrible, of dead person, cadaver, greatest tendency to hemorrhage from every orifice including skin and blood in semen, easily tired, sudden and great prostration of vital force, coldness like ice in abdomen with ulcers, yellow conjunctiva, skin and tongue. Next is Borthrops lanceolatus. It's an pit viper. Pit viper venom has more neurotoxicity, bringing about paralysis and thromboembolic effect. It is useful in cases of diabetic retinopathy, day blindness, insanity, inability to articulate without any affection of tongue, paralysis of one arm and one leg only, deep gangrene, necrotic lesions reaching up to the bones. Next is Elaps corallinus. It's coral snake. Disorganizes blood and produces paralysis. Horror of rain or likes rain and loves countryside. Imagines he hears someone talk. Sudden nightly deafness. Dreads to be left alone, yet does not wish to be spoken to. Nosebleed, hemoptysis, stool black like ink, desire for sweetened buttermilk, bites hand during sleep. Now see lesser known snakes. Hydrophis cynocinctus, sea snake. It is very poisonous. Toxicophis, that is moccasin snake. Pain and fever recurs annually at same time. Clotho erectens, unreasonable and over the top anger for trifles with insane and wild behavior. Thanks for watching the video. If you have found value in this video, then please do like, share and comment on my video and subscribe to my channel Dynamic Medicos.